I love the way you put it on your eyes. The roses on your face light up the sky. Those lips are colorful all of the time. And girl, that's fine, but I wanna know, do you mind? No makeup today. No makeup today.
She looked, I tell her beautiful and how long it took for you to put it on. It was early in the morning. She resembled a model hide of a
man. What's up, family? It's your girl Empress Nsaba. I know y'all ain't seen me in a while, but I'm back now, and I'm gonna do this video real quick. This is my big drop. Okay, so you know everybody got their videos. A lot of sisters, what they did their big chop. Get the hair started natural. I wasn't into doing videos or on the internet in order to do that for myself when I went natural, but I did chop it all off. But this, the big drop, is me getting free. big drop, okay. I'm just gonna get to it, let y'all know what it is. My little makeup bag right here is not as full as it used to be. I used to have, it was full, plus I had two other little bags that I had some other makeup pieces in. And gradually I've been weaning myself off. I started with coming off of my eyeshadows and if y'all ever seen the makeup tutorial videos, like, that's the type of stuff that I was into. Like, the whole blending of the colors and all of that. Yeah, I was into all of that. I never did the foundation. Never did the lipstick. I was all about this. Like, my Catwoman mask or something. Like, yeah, that's it. Like, just doing the eyes, whether it be eyeshadow, eyeliner, mascara, all of that. That's me. I'm on the eyes trying to make them pop. But, so this is it. Right now, I'm down to very, very, very little. The last week, I want to really give myself more than that. But I'm going to say the last week I've been rocking my fresh face. That's what, what I've been calling it. Blank face. With nothing. No mascara. No eyeliner. No eyeshadow. Nothing. Just get up, wash my face, and do what I got to do. So I'm trying to get free, y'all. That's what it's about. But this is what I do have left of my makeup. A little cheap ass eyeshadow palette I bought from a beauty supply store that I haven't wore in forever, but I still got it because them just in case moments. That's what I just been hanging on to, just in case I might have some type of event to attend and I need. Why? This one, Black Radiance, as if my black ain't radiant enough. Black Radiance, I got from my mama, and hopefully she don't see this video because she might be pissed that I threw her shit away. But this is it, Black Radiance, another little eyeshadow palette. My L'Oreal Double Extend mascara for my lashes. Mega Protein mascara, MAC concealer, and a MAC electric blue eyeshadow, and my teeny weeny. This shows you how much I use these. Look how little these pencils are. These started out as tall as pencils. Look how small they are, both of them. That's how hard I be on this, doing my little cat woman Egyptianist style eyes. I don't know what you want to call it, but that's what I do. And that's it. That's all I got left. I'm down. I'm down to the bare minimum of my makeup, what I got left, and here you go. Into the trash, my big drop. Bye. Bye. And I'm gonna be real honest, the only thing that I really wanna hang on to is my mascara and this little eyeliner pencil. But fuck it, what I'm holding on to it for. I'm gonna, empty makeup bag. And when I got this bag, the whole thing was this light pink color. Look how much makeup I done had in this bag, where the inside of the bag is makeup colored. This bag, like the whole bag is makeup colored. Why hold on to the bag? They can go too. Enough respect to my sister Bungalow for rocking it all the way natural. I aspire to be like that one day. We're not twisting up the locks and all, but as you can see right now, I'm still twisting on these things. To all my beautiful sisters, this is something that we all gotta realize. We don't need any extra added anything. I got smudged my face with something. We don't need any extra added anything. We came as we are, beautiful as we are. Accept yourself as you are. And while I'm talking to you, I'm talking to me too. I gotta let it go. We gotta let it go. So that's my big drop. It's gone. It's in the trash. And I will not be digging it out. And I have to make myself the promise that I will not be purchasing anymore. And the only thing I will really want to buy is mascara. But I'm not gonna do it. It's my eyelashes with nothing on them. I don't need it. I'm gonna rock my blank face. That's it, y'all. Peace.
What'd it do? Oh, y'all thought y'all wasn't gonna see me? Yeah. I know some of y'all wishing that you didn't see me right now, but hey, too fucking bad. I was asked to do this addendum. I didn't just bum rush the show like I did on last video. She liked my addendum on the Cracked Black shit, so she asked me to do this. So here I am, put my two cents in it. You know what I mean? I tried to stay out this girl talk shit. I really been trying to stay away from it, even though that's some shit I've been wanting to say. And I'm going to get back around to that, trust me. To all the ladies who appreciated my videos before they got flagged. Fuck you flaggots, by the way. But yeah, I'm getting back around to all that. It's coming, so I'm going to save some of that for that, for those videos, and try to keep this shit short, sweet. I don't really have much to add, just that, once again, you know, me publicly commend her for making that step. I think it's vital, man, like, for y'all to just get to know yourselves again, just you, how you are, like, I honestly feel like a lot of you done forgot what you actually look like. You got caught up in the illusion like everybody else. It's like some of y'all got men who ain't never seen you without your hat and your face on, your mask, rather. You know, some of y'all ain't seen yourselves without it. Not long enough to get used to it. So, I think it's very healthy to do that. To just go a while with just you, being you, until you learn to love it. Then worry about all that other shit. Worry about special occasions and what you're going to do when it's time to go out and all that later. Once you get comfortable with yourself. But one thing I do want to say, you know, to all y'all who I already know what a lot of bitches are going to say. Oh, you let that nigga tell you to throw away your mascara, girl. You let that nigga tell you to put away your makeup. You let that nigga tell you. You let that nigga tell you. Yeah, all that shit. I know how bitches think. But just for the record, I ain't told her to do shit. If it was up to me, she would have did that shit a long time ago. If it was just some shit I was going to tell her to do. But I don't tell people what they should and should not do. But I do challenge them. Anybody who claiming to be, for lack of a better word, conscious. But if you operating in right knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, man, then you're going to have to be able to withstand questioning. Everything you do should be able to withstand questioning. You should be able to justify what you're doing with a reasonable response. A good reason for everything you do. Everything. There shouldn't be no exceptions to that. You know, so I continue to challenge, and I get that attitude a lot. That, you know, I said that to her one time, just joking, and she couldn't do nothing but laugh because I know she was thinking it. I know it comes up, it's in your programming. And when I say, oh, I'm just trying to make sense out of it, you say, why the fuck does everything got to make sense? Why you got to make sense out of everything? Like, that shit get frustrating to people. And I know this shit. I done been through that shit plenty of times before. Like, oh, you break down everything. Why you gotta break down everything? That's what a girl told me once before. Because I just, every time she said something, I'm breaking down every word she say, trying to tell her what's wrong with it. She just started getting frustrated with that shit. Like, you gotta break down everything. I'm like, shit, you don't break down nothing, no. That's the problem. And that's been a lot of our problems, period. We ain't broke down none of this shit that we do. We just been doing stuff. Somebody asks you why you do it. I don't know. I just do it. My mama did it. My grandmama did it. Oh, I just like it. You just like it? Or I just do it for me. Like all that type of dumb bullshit. You know what I'm saying? I don't even like talking to them type of people. If you're not even really willing to be honest with yourself, you'll never be honest with me. You're going to have to be honest with yourself first. If you truly believe your face is just a canvas and it's just there for decoration, then go right ahead. You probably feel the same way about the rest of your body, and I don't have nothing to say about all that. We've done all that. We do all that. And I know it's some latent DNA going on, you know, that same reason why niggas wore high top fades and spun around on their back and did all that shit. These things were in our DNA to do. We ain't do nothing but put our Egyptian headdresses back on, start doing capoeira, calling it breakdancing. We don't even know what the fuck we doing or why. But it's in you to do it. So I get the argument that, oh, the Egyptians wore their eyes like that. The Egyptians wore wigs. And yeah, they did do these things. But first of all, men and women did those things, and y'all don't want us going back to that. Secondly, they had reasons and ceremonial occasions for that shit. Rituals. This shit was ritualistic. Some of the shit was just to protect them from the sun. Like, a lot of the shit, y'all have no idea why they did it. Don't even give a fuck. That's not, you don't have no intention of finding out or living like an Egyptian. Like I say all the time, it'd be the very women arguing with me about polygamy and polygyny. They'll be walking around trying to look like an Egyptian or wrapped up like a fucking African. Like, get the fuck out of here, man. I don't want to see none of that shit. Take all that shit off until you're ready to live that shit. And that's some serious shit right there. Otherwise, you just putting on. You fucking fake. You just as fake as you were when you had your Lee Press on nails and your motherfucking fur hat on. So, that's what I want to say about that. Y'all need to cut that Egyptian shit out. Stop throwing that shit up until you making your own shit. Naturally, you don't know what's in that shit. You don't know what you putting on in your body. You don't know. So stop it until you can withstand the questioning. Till you can do it. That's everything you do. Everything. No exception. You should be asking yourself, why am I doing that? And where did I get this shit from? So let's just keep it G. It's not a man and woman issue. Everything you find women doing, you will find some men doing right now and all throughout history. Everything. Men wear makeup to this day. Every man y'all motherfucking think is cute and fine on TV and videos and movies, all them niggas got on makeup. They wear makeup every day. Anytime they get on their camera. Now you gonna make an exception. Certain types of makeup are okay. It's okay for niggas to wear makeup sometimes, only when they on TV. Come on now. Maybe that's a girl thing or it's not. It's not. It's a cosmetic thing. And men go have cosmetic surgery just like women do. And everything else is going on. Men wearing weaves. Men motherfucking painting their beards after they shape them up. Like, that's worse than mascara. Like, y'all niggas just really on some other shit. But I ain't even get into all these niggas claiming to be straight. That's what I'm saying. Like, come on, we gotta stop that bullshit. Stop trying to make being a girl an excuse to fuck yourself up. How would you want to keep doing shit that you know is uncomfortable, taking up time in your day when it's just not necessary? And let me make sure, let me say this before I talk too long. It's not enough to just say you don't need it. Because y'all know you don't fucking need it. It's not water or air. You know that, even though some of y'all act like you need that shit. You know it's not a necessity. But not only do you not need it, it's just not an enhancement. It's not an improvement. That's what you need to get through your head. Like, you do not look better after you do that shit. You don't. Never. Ever. None of y'all. I ain't never seen one yet that looked better after you painted your fucking eyelashes aqua blue. Or pink. Or pink with blue in the middle. Like, how the fuck does that look better than the natural tone of your eyes that matches your whole fucking face? You don't think your face don't look better just because your eyes match your clothes? That's what I need y'all to get to your head, man. I ain't seen a woman yet that looked better after her makeup tutorial than she did before she started. Yeah, I ain't seen it yet. I'm not saying you don't look good. I'm saying you don't look better. And that's what I need. That's what I keep asking. Why would you go through a process? Why would you do anything to yourself that does not make you better? Does it make sense? That's all I'm asking. Does that make sense? Anything you're doing. If it don't make you look better than you did, then really the only alternative to that is worse. Either you look worse, you look better, or you look the same. And I'm pretty sure I talked about this before, but hey, it can stand repeating. If you look the same, then you just wasted your time, right? If you do something, if you spend an hour in the mirror and then you just leave out of the fucking bathroom looking exactly the way you did when you went in there, why waste your time? So you obviously are trying to look better. You wouldn't do anything to yourself to purposely look worse. It's common sense shit, man. So I'm just telling you from a man who don't have to, who's not concerned with getting your pussy. So I don't have to tell you what you want to hear. I can tell you the truth. And even sometimes it don't even matter if your man tell you the truth, you know. Some of y'all gonna have to get that shit through your head some kind of way. It's gotta click in your head. You gotta know that you look good without that shit. You gotta know that you look better without that shit. It ain't gonna matter what I say until you believe it yourself. Till you know it. Fuck belief. you need to know this. So, you know, I know it don't, what I say don't hold much weight, but this is what I did. All I did, and I'm encouraging other brothers to do what I'm doing, which is encourage your woman to be her natural self. Look, and I know y'all think we like all that shit. Like, that's what I've heard that. I've been told that, you know, part of the problem is some men like it, and we respond to that, or we compliment y'all on all that shit, right? But let me give y'all the scoop, man. Let me tell y'all the truth, a secret. Partners, we do not like that shit. We like two things. This is what men like. We like what we've been trained to like, and we like pussy. Y'all need to hear me on this, man. We like what we've been trained to like, and I'm talking about starting from the breast. Mama, that first image, and I already told y'all this shit before, that first image, it was became the standard of beauty. So, from then on, every woman I saw had to meet that criteria. She had to look like mama. I would never, you ain't gonna never hear a man say his mama is ugly or unattractive. Your mama is the most beautiful woman in the world to you. You gotta break out of that spell. It take a man, you know, it take a certain level of consciousness to say to yourself, damn, mama was throwed off. Mama never liked how she looked. I might never even seen how my mama really looked. So you got to break yourself out of that, brothers. Stop liking what you've been trained to like. Auntie, sister, grandmama, all of them. Everywhere I looked growing up, I saw Barbies and women living after the image and likeness of the beast. So, of course, I grew up thinking that was attractive. That's all I saw. That's all I knew. Two, men like pussy. So, like I said before, if your woman spend 2 hours in the bathroom or in the room in her front of her vanity getting ready, she come down the steps, y'all finna go out, she's expecting you. This is another part of our training. We've been well trained to know you better say something, nigga. You better acknowledge her. You better tell her how good she looked. She just spent a lot of time trying to get dolled up for you. Right? Ain't that what y'all say in the same breath while you lying like you did all that shit for yourself? Retarded ass motherfuckers. Anyway. So, yes. We know we supposed to tell you that shit look good. Of course. You want some pussy later on tonight, don't you, nigga? Don't you want to fuck when you get home? So lie and say you like this shit so you can just get her out all of that shit at the end of the night. Your objective is to get all that shit off. Fucking right. Makeup and all. We don't want to fuck you with that shit on. That shit gonna get all over me. So we don't like it. I'm telling you what we talk about behind your back. I'm telling you. I used to have, man, every woman on my team looked like what I'm telling y'all I don't like right now. And when they would leave, I'd get on the phone with my homegirl and dog they ass out. And she'd just be tripping like, she said, these girls would have a heart attack if they knew what you really thought about them. Probably so. And that's fucked up. I ain't saying I'm not proud of that. That's not good. It's better to just not fuck with them. But like I told Empress, yeah, if I would have followed that, I wouldn't have fucked with nobody. In the atmosphere and environment I was in, if I was sitting around waiting for some India Irie, Erykah Badu looking chick to walk through the door, it would have, you know, never happened. Or if she did walk through the door, she got her husband on her arm. Come on now. A single lady look. You got fur claws, paint and everything. But anyway, that was the point. We don't like it. We just like y'all. And we'll tell y'all whatever you got on look good if we think that's what's gonna get the pussy. I promise you. Wrap your head up. We'll compliment you on that the same way we do your fur hat. Take your makeup off. We will tell you you're pretty, just like you do when you ain't got it on. And all y'all already admitted that when you go outside looking so-called any kind of way, hair pulled to the back, jogging pants, plain face, what happens? Niggas coming out the woodwork. They everywhere. You can't get a fucking break. You can't pump some gas. You can't go in the grocery store. You can't do shit. Everybody trying to holler at you. Matter of fact, all y'all got the same story. How do I know that? I remember my mama saying that. That's how long I've been hearing that. And now, to this day, I still hear women say the same shit. And y'all ain't got the message yet. We do not prefer you looking like a clown. Only clowns would prefer that. Like Common said it best. Real hair and real eyes get real guys, man. Simple. So there it is, man. That's the truth. Y'all who think we like it. We like to tell you whatever the fuck you want to hear. Because we like pussy. It's a waste of your time. Get free. That's what this is about. Freeing yourself. And I'm going to keep challenging. I'm going to keep challenging her just like I'm going to keep challenging y'all. She got past that hurdle. And I already know women give me this too. Like, damn, nigga, I done did this. Ain't I natural enough? I ain't wearing no weave. I ain't got no perm. I just like my hair. I just stopped wearing them shit makeup. Ain't I natural enough? I'm like, you'll never be natural enough for me as long as you want to keep trying to use that. Because nature is natural enough for me. Like, until we are totally in tune, I ain't gonna never be happy. I ain't gonna never be satisfied. So stop trying. Don't try to satisfy me. That'll never work. Just do it. Do what you can justify. That's all you gotta do. Stick to that. Don't do nothing that you're not willing to defend. Logically. You know? I think that was about it. I don't talk too long already. Get back to the imperfection. Death to the Barbie. Blessing from heaven is where you get it from. I love your smile. You can do it without style. From your lips all the way to your eyebrows. It's the beauty in her, but when the makeup occur, I don't see it. All I see is a blur.
Put it on your eyes. The roses on your face light up the sky. Those lips are colorful all of the time. And girl, that's fine, but I wanna know, do you mind? No makeup today. No makeup today. No makeup today.